Hey everyone, with hundreds of SEO tools out on the market, how do you know which one is going to make the difference? Could Semrush be the secret weapon that you're looking for to help you crush your competition? Well, stay tuned because we're going to take a deep dive into Semrush, what it can do, and how it can help you with your website or your clients' websites to increase traffic and rankings. So let's go. So first off, Semrush is a comprehensive digital marketing platform. It's packed with tools for SEO, content marketing, PPC, competitor analysis, and so forth. Whether you're a beginner or a seasoned pro when it comes to SEO, Semrush is designed to give you actionable insights into what you can do to improve your performance. Now, one question I get all the time is, well, aren't there free tools out there like the Google Keyword Planner and Analytics and Search Console that would give me a lot of the same data that Semrush has? And the answer is yes and no. Yes, there is data, but you have to use three different platforms, and it's really hard to kind of compile all that data in a way that makes it actionable and understandable to an SEO to be able to make decisions. Semrush kind of takes all of that hard work of grabbing and scraping and taking all of that data and putting it together so that it's just easier and faster for you as an SEO to take a look at data, track keywords, look at traffic trends, and help you to do keyword research to help you move the needle when it comes to content marketing. So one way I like to think about it is to liken it to, say, cars. Sure, you can buy a really cheap car that has four wheels and has a gas pedal and will get you from point A to point B, but it may not have a lot of features that, say, you know, a high-end vehicle would have that just kind of make your ride a lot easier, faster, and more enjoyable. In that sense, Semrush is definitely that high-end fancy car that has a ton of features that can just make the experience of doing SEO a little bit easier, a little bit faster, and a little bit more enjoyable. And that's definitely my opinion based on having used Semrush for the last 10 years, as well as other platforms. Semrush does have a ton of bells and whistles. Some are great, some are not so great, and we're gonna get into that right now. All right, so here I am inside of the main dashboard in Semrush, and one thing that I really like about Semrush is it has this domain overview. So this is great if you wanna just take a quick high-level overview of a website, or if you're trying to sell clients on SEO services, this is really helpful to get a quick read or diagnosis of what that website is experiencing, what their previous history was, and kind of what the trends are looking like. So for example, you can put in any domain here that you like. I'm gonna go ahead and just type in one of our publishing domains. It's an affiliate site, just to give you guys some context. So once you put in the domain, you're gonna get some instant information, which is really helpful. Again, you would have to use three or four different free tools to get all this information, but it's right here in one dashboard here on Semrush. So you can see the authority score of this website. If you click on this, you can actually see history of how that site authority has changed over time. So for example, you can see that the authority score was 24 at one point, it's gone down to 13 and it's come back up. We've done a little bit of work on this site to kind of keep it there after some of these core updates have happened this year. And it also gives you some insight into, you know, how the authority score is being made up from, you know, the natural profile versus the organic profile and the link power. And it has explanations of what these things are or how Semrush defines them. You'll notice that this is a little bit different between platforms such as Ahrefs, Moz. They have different sort of metrics that make up what their authority score is, or their domain authority is what Moz calls it. So there is some difference between the platforms, but ultimately you're looking at about the same thing when it comes to what these numbers represent. Now, if I click back and we go back to the main domain overview, you can see what the organic search traffic is like, how many backlinks. Again, these things are all clickable. So if I wanted to see where the backlinks are coming from this site, I can see how many follow, no follow we have. And then it's going to actually give us, you know, the sources that are actually pointing back to the site. So this is, again, really quick, really easy, right? If I had the look in Search Console for this versus analytics, yeah, I could probably find this information, but it would take me a really long time to get all of that kind of in one spot to make sense of it all. So if we go back to the main domain overview, the other thing I really like about this is it shows traffic trends as well as keyword trends. So you can see that this affiliate site got hammered by the March core update. We were a casualty of that update, but there were two updates just done in December, and you can see that the site is bouncing back with traffic and with keywords. But this is a really good way for you to show a client or to see yourself or your own website how the traffic has changed. It'll also kind of show you when algorithmic updates were potentially made to show you if those correlate with changes in traffic and keywords. So this is a really good way to just give you some quick historical data on how things have been going for this site. Here is something that I also really enjoy about this main overview is it has an organic keywords section. So if I click view details on this organic research, This is really, really nice. And this is nice because it's showing me the organic keywords that this website is ranking for, what position it is on Google, how much traffic and, you know, keyword difficulty the keyword has that we're actually doing well for or ranking for. And this information is hard to get from analytics and Search Console. It's just much easier in a tool like this to be able to see how am I doing and what words am I actually ranking for on this website, and what is the potential of traffic that these keywords have if I was to say, you know, move from position 11 to position 1 on this keyword. Here's another really big thing that I like about Semrush is that it shows you the keywords by intent. Intent is the biggest thing that has changed in SEO in the last few years. It now matters more than ever that the intent of the keyword actually matches what the query means. So, is the query that the user is making informational? Or is it with a transactional intent? Because if you have a blog post that's informational that's targeting a transactional keyword, it's probably not going to rank very well on Google because the query doesn't match the intent. So being able to see what the intent is of keywords is something that you just can't do in the Google Keyword Planner. Another really nice thing about this overview that I like is the competitor analysis, right? So it's showing me, based on Semrush's data, who it thinks my main competitors are. This is good for two reasons. Number one, it's doing this based off of keyword data, traffic, links. So there might be some competitors here that are my competitors or who are not my competitors. But what matters is what does Google think my competitors are? And that can be a real telltale sign as to maybe what sort of strategic shifts you need to make, right? Like, do I need to have different types of content? Is my intent correct? Do I need to be making some strategic changes to that in order to kind of change what Google and Semrush view my competitors to be? I also kind of like this positioning map where it shows you how much traffic and keywords you're kind of eating up in your competitor space. So this is really helpful and good for clients, in my opinion, to show them visually. And I appreciate charts like this because it makes it a little bit easier to show clients in a visual way how their competitors may be eating their lunch or how they may be eating their competitors' lunch when it comes to traffic and keywords. There's another feature I really like in Semrush, which is their magic tool, which is basically their way of doing keyword research. And we also have some great videos on how to do keyword research using Semrush. So I'm going to put a link to that in the description below so that you can check that out. But I'm just going to give you a quick overview of this tool. So if we click on the keyword magic tool, this is where we can type in keywords and it's going to give us some information. So for example, if I have a gardening website and I want to type in something like gardening tools, I can hit search and it's going to take a look and come up with keywords and give me some really valuable data. The data that I want to know about is the search volume that these keywords have, the keyword difficulty, the higher, the harder it's going to be to rank for. So you want to look for low ones. And then this is something that I really appreciate that Semrush gives, which is the intent. What is the intent of this keyword? So that'll help me to know if I need to write content that is informational or if I need to be working on content that is more transactional for these keywords. Again, intent is something that is not given to you on a free tool like the Google Keyword Planner. So this is where Semrush does have quite a bit of value when it comes to keyword research. And we see a lot of success and have seen a lot of success using Semrush over the years with keyword research. It does a pretty good job. It is pretty accurate when it comes to intent, volume numbers, and the KD. And we do use this all the time in our agency with a lot of success to be able to find good low competition keywords that we can move the needle on. Now, inside of this magic tool, it also has a questions section. So I can click on questions. If I'm needing some help with ideation, it'll kind of show me what sort of questions are being asked. And these are actual keywords themselves. I can change from broad match, phrase match, exact match, all that kind of stuff is very similar in most keyword tools between, you know, Ahrefs, Google Keyword Planner, and so forth. They also have tools for local SEO to do citation building. These are all things that come in at additional cost. And there are honestly some other solutions that I use that I think are a little bit better value than Semrush here. So that would be one con that I have for Semrush is that I think their local tools are good. They're just a little bit on the pricier side. And that kind of leads me to my next point of conversation. How does pricing work with Semrush? So if we take a look at their pricing model, they have three main tiers. They have a pro, guru, and a business, and you obviously get a better deal if you pay annually versus monthly. And the main differences between these pricing tiers are projects, which are essentially you have the ability to put a website in and it will start to track it. So you have 5 project spots for it to be able to do, you know, keyword tracking, all that kind of stuff, where it will just really help you to see how a website that you're working on has changed? Are you making progress? Are you making it worse with your SEO strategy? It just gives you some more high level overview analytics and reporting. And then also the number of keywords that you want to track. So if you're working on a massive website, 500 keywords just isn't going to be enough. But if you're working on lots of really small client websites, 500 keywords might be plenty. And then they're reporting, right? Data costs money, you know, for them to go out and to scour the web and scrape content. You know, they give you about 10,000 results per report here. But if you go over that, you have to pay for that. And it's pretty dang expensive. They charge hundreds of dollars to be able to pull extra reports. So make sure that you're aware of that. Their next tier up is their guru. You can have 15 projects, 1,500 keywords to track, 30,000 results. And then if you're a big boy that's doing lots of stuff, you know, 40 projects, 5,000 keywords, 50,000 results per report on their business plan. So that leads me to the biggest con of Semrush is the pricing. The pricing is expensive. If you are not a well-established SEO agency, Semrush may not be the right tool for you just based on money. But if you are a well-established agency, Semrush, in my opinion, has a lot of really good tools that can help a mid-sized agency to really grow and help their clients. And if pricing is a problem for you, we've actually partnered with Semrush to be able to give you a free 7-day trial of Semrush so that you can check it out and make sure if it's the right tool for you. To get the free 7-day trial, simply click our affiliate link in our description below. So now that we've gone over some of the features and the pricing of Semrush, the ultimate question is Semrush worth it? In my opinion, yes. We've been using Semrush for over 10 years. We've had a really good relationship with them, and it's become an integral part of our process over here to be able to help clients to increase their traffic and their rankings, and we have the proof to back it up that it actually works. So if you're looking for a high-end, fancy SEO tool to be able to give you the data that you need in a quick, concise way to make decisions, Semrush may be a good fit for you. And like I said, if you want to try Semrush free for 7 days, click our affiliate link below to be able to give it a shot. If this video has been helpful, please make sure you hit like, subscribe, and turn on notifications so that you'll be notified when we put out more helpful content like this. And if you want to learn how to do more advanced keyword research using a tool like Semrush, make sure to watch this video where we go in detail the exact process that we use here at BKA Content to be able to do high-end keyword research. Thank you so much for joining me today, and we'll see you on the next video.